talk about some results exist among conditional integral transform, conditional convolution product, and first variation defined on the space K0T. And furthermore, we can obtain some generalized version of the above meaning. this space is introduced by many speakers already. This one be the Wiener space, and this Wiener space, and we denote the Wiener integral, Wiener integral function defined by this one. And this space introduced by another speaker, K0T. This history is already introduced by Professor Eun-sik Chi. In 1982, U.J. Lee defined an integral transform integral transform on C0T. Integral transform on X functional Wiener space. And 2004, Kim, Skog, and myself established various relationships among integral transform, convolution product, and first variation for functionals on K0T. K0T is the space of a complex valued continuous function on 0T, which vanishes at 0. we define the integral transform of F by this one, and we define the convolution product of F and G defined by this formula. And we also define the first variation of F by this one. It looks like a partial derivative. Now, we can see the integral transform of analytic functional on abstract Wiener space could be the following as a special cases. When alpha equal 1 and beta equal I, this one called the Fourier Wiener transform by Cameron and Martin, and alpha equal I and beta equal 1, then it's a Gauss transform. In this talk, we want to study the existence of a conditional integral transform, conditional convolution product, and the first variation. Second, various relations among these three concepts, and some examples. Last, we can obtain the generalized concept of these three concepts. In this paper, Bong Jin Kim established the formula for the conditional integral, Wiener integral, represented by the ordinary Wiener integral by this form. This formula introduced by Professor Cho. For K, we define the conditional Wiener integral of this form, and convolution product of F and G defined by this one. Next, we describe the class of functionals that we work with this talk. Let theta 1, this one be the complete orthonormal set of real valued continuous function in L2. Each theta j is bound variation on 0t, that one denotes the total variation of theta j. Then for each y, the Riemann Schulze integral, this one exists and bounded by this one. For sigma 0 to 1, E sigma with the space of all continuous functions F of the form, or cylinder form, for some positive integer n, where F lambda 1 is an entire function of n complex values of exponential type bounded by this one. Kim, Skogen, and myself find this space. We use the reflection principle. It's a reflection principle, which means that lambda, sum norm lambda, greater than lambda is that if t, then this one and that one is 50%. Such in E sigma F and G, F and G using the same positive integers, that is G equal this form. For example, if G F equal this one and G equal that one, then we can express F and G with for n equal 4 by choosing that F is R and G equal S this one form. When we evaluate conditional integral transform F, we can encounter the Riemann Schulze integral, and we write this one by that one. This BJ is that one. Now. Even though the set of functions, this one, are orthonormal set of functions, but this one need not be even orthogonal. In fact, m equal length of span of this one may be less than n. However, using Gram-Schmidt orthonormalization procedure, we can find the orthonormal functions phi 1, phi n, each bound the variation on 0t with the span of this one equal span of that one. Furthermore, if m is less than, less than n, we can find n minus m functions, phi m plus 1 to phi n, each of bound variation on 0t, such that these are orthonormal on 0t. In view of the above, we can find an n by n matrix C, CJK, with that one. For example, if my if t equal 1, then theta 1, theta 1 is a characteristic.
theta 2 equal root sum characteristic theta 3 equal and this one and that one. Then we can find matrix C theta 1 minus then B1 is BI is square root 3 over 3 B1 equal 3 then theta 1 minus B1 theta 2 minus B2 theta 3 minus B3 equal phi 1 phi 3 and this one, say C. C. I see. This phi 1, phi 2, phi 3, we obtained by orthogonalization. Of course, the functions phi 1, phi 1 are not unique. If P1 or Pm is any set of orthogonal functions bound variation on 0 to T, with span of this one equal span of that one, then with theta minus B equal PCT DJ K equal 0, this form, then we have this one would be this one and equal this one. Hence, our results are independent of which orthonormal set phi 1, phi n is chosen. And we will see the simple example in the next section. For f in is sigma, conditional integral transform exists and belongs to sigma and is given by the formula this one. We can sketch a proof but I'll skip this one. And theorem 2 is exists a theorem of conditional convolution product of f and g. Also f and g are in E sigma. This theorem says if f is in E sigma, then this one, the first variation of f is f exists and this form. And this one as a function of y, W is fixed as a function of y, then first variation is an element of E sigma with coefficients B equal this one and the coefficient A equal that one. Furthermore, as a function of W, the first variation is an element also E sigma with coefficient B equal 1 and coefficient A equal this one. Yeah. For example, let gamma equal or square root 1 over 2, 1 over root 1 over root t on 0. Then fy equal set of such that set 1 equal or gamma t. Then b1 equal or root 1 over root t and bj equal 0 for all j. Hence, this one could be this one. So rank of this one is n minus 1. Thus, we can choose a set of orthonormal sets, P1, Pn, each bound variation, 0, t, with phi j equal theta j plus 1 for
j equal 1 to n minus 1. Then we have theta 1 minus p 1. This vector can be written by that one. Relationships on these three concepts, we need this lemma. There are distinct relationships involving these three concepts. First one says the conditional integral transform or conditional convolution product can be written by the product of conditional integral transforms. And this one says that the conditional transform of the first variation could be written by the summation of conditional integral transforms. There are 10 distinct relationships involving all three concepts, which concept is usually exact ones. It's very complicated.
Now, okay. For the example,
in this section, we briefly discussed these functionals, which are E sigma. Then first one, F lambda equal this one, and G equal this one, and H lambda equal this one. Then we have the following results. For the above functional F and H, we can find this one. This one can be written this one. This one says that the conditional integral transform of conditional convolution product can be obtained by without computing the conditional convolution product. This one is another example. Last section, we obtain the generalized version of the condition x equal zhx. This one is a Gaussian process of this one. This one is already introduced by another speaker. Then we can define the generalized conditional integral transform F given by XH by the formula of this one, and define the generalized conditional convolution product of this one, and we define the generalized first variation this formula introduced by Professor. When H equal 1, 0 t, then the generalized conditional integral transform and generalized convolution products leads to the conditional integral transform and conditional convolution products respectively, which are defined by above. That is, F, then X1 equal F alpha beta, this one, and conditional convolution product of X1 equal the conditional, conditional convolution product of this one. When H1 equal H2 equal 1, 0 t, then our definition could be written by that one. Using the formula expression conditional exponential with an integral with conditioning this one, we have this formula. It's similar method the early sections. This one will be similar to the section 3. And, for each. The last section, we need the following lemma, 6.1. Skip the proof of lemma. For fng in e sigma and for y in k, we have the convolution product of generalized conditional integral transforms could be written by this formula. And another formulas are very complicated. And we have another next formulas. Thank you.
Any questions or comments? Okay, thank you for the nice talk.